Answers first. A 5 amp hour supplied 130 amps but failed to start the car. A 12 amp hour supplied 144 amps and started the car with ease. The highest I got the car's electrical system was 17 volts. There are lots of videos and posts about jump-starting cars with 18-volt lithium power tool batteries. The comments always descend into whether the 18-volt battery, which is 20.5 volts fully charged, will overvolt the car's electrical system, which typically operates at 14.5 volts. There's also the argument that the higher starter motor current will damage the power tool battery. But no one has any numbers on this, it's all just speculation. The car that we'll be doing the testing on is a 4-cylinder 2.5-litre 2003 Subaru Forester, and the temperature on the day was 21 Celsius. The car battery was 6 years old and was on its way out. The car had not been driven in about 8 weeks and its voltage was down to 7.4 volts, which is quite deeply discharged. Normally a car battery will be at about 12 to 12.6 volts at rest, and below 11 volts is where it will struggle to start. Starting current for this car was measured at 233 amps when cold and 170 amps on another attempt 2 minutes later. The two power tool batteries we'll be testing are Milwaukee 18 volt 5 amp hour and 12 amp hour batteries. The 5 amp hour is made up of 10 18650 cells, which are Samsung 25R, and they are rated to 20 amps continuous or 100 amps for 1 second. As the pack has two parallel strings, the rating for the pack is 40 amps continuous and 200 amps for 1 second. The 12 amp hour is 15 21700 cells, which are Samsung 40T, and they are rated for 30 amps continuous. The pack has three parallel strings, which gives an overall rating of 90 amps. The first test was with the 5 amp hour. When the jumper leads are connected, we can see around 33 amps flow from the lithium battery, which is comfortably below its 40 amp rating. The 18 volt battery sags from 20.5 volts down to 17 volts, and the car battery gets pushed up to 15 volts. So we're losing about 3.5 volts from the battery's resistance and 2 volts from the jumper lead's resistance. 15 volts is not significantly over the 14.5 volts that the car battery would normally get from the alternator. Turning the ignition fails to start the car, and we see it hit a peak current of 130 amps. We also see the 18 volt battery's voltage sagging down to 7 volts, whilst the car battery sagged down to 0.2 volts. That means all of that remaining 7 volts from the power tool battery were dropped over the jumper leads and nearly none made it across the motor. So despite the motor having a large current going through it, there was almost no voltage and therefore not enough RPM to start the engine. I got out of the car to check the voltages and currents to make sure they weren't too wild, and then got back in for a second attempt. The second attempt was very similar to the first, 123 amps, the 18 volt battery sagging down to 6.5 volts, and the car battery going down to 2.2 volts. With the 5 amp hour failing, I tried the more powerful 12 amp hour battery. On hooking it up, we see it holding 18 volts instead of the 5 amp hour's 17 volts, and we see the current settling at around 50 amps, well within spec. The extra juice has pushed the car's electrical system up to 16 volts though. This time the car starts with ease, peak current recorded was 144 amps, but the voltage held up much higher. 13 volts at the lithium battery and 8 volts at the car battery. We previously saw that it took 233 amps to start when cold and 170 amps when warm. It might be that the two failed starts with the 5 amp hour lubricated the engine enough to lower the starting current, or it might be that the car battery provided 10 to 100 amps of assistance. This test really needs a second clamp meter, measuring the current going out of the car battery. Notice the current from the power tool battery increases from 50 amps to 60 amps after the engine starts. I think this extra current is going to powering the car's electrical systems. Normally the alternator will be providing the electrical power for the car, but the alternator only puts out 14.5 volts. So whilst the car battery is at 15 volts, nothing will be getting past the alternator's rectifier circuit. It's probably best to disconnect the pack fairly quickly to avoid over-discharging or overheating the power tool battery. Another way of doing this jump is to connect a power tool battery and leave it there for a few minutes in order to give the car battery a bit of extra charge. I wanted to see if this would cause overvoltage on a low but not completely dead car battery. This test was done 6 days later when the car battery had self-discharged to 11.9 volts. Also in this test I had a third multimeter measuring the voltage across the ground jumper cable so I could tie all the voltages of the circuit together. It showed the jumper leads to have a combined resistance of about 55 milliohms. The 5 amp hour pulled the car battery up to just under 16 volts before I ended the test. It looks like it would have settled at around 16.5 volts and 17 amps. At that rate, the battery would be drained in about 15 minutes, but I would aim for 10 minutes max. The same test was done with the 12 amp hour, and we can see it settling at 17 volts and 30 amps. This will take a bit over 20 minutes to drain, so 15 minutes should be safe. I personally don't think there's a risk of overvolting the car, but use at your own risk. The highest voltage we got was 17 volts, which isn't a lot higher than the car's operating voltage of 14 to 15 volts. There isn't any public information about what cars are designed for, but I'd be very surprised if they couldn't handle an extra 2 volts for a few minutes. The currents through the lithium battery were within the continuous discharge limits when just connected to the car battery. They get quite high during starting attempts, but it's within Samsung's 1-second burst spec. If the car doesn't start within 2 seconds, then stop and let it trickle charge for a few minutes. If anyone else out there has 2 clamp meters and a flat battery, it would be great to see what results you get and how much current comes from the car battery.